It's Queens, baby.
Yo, Uncle Ralph out there.
Yo, what's good, Uncle Ralph?
What's up, Ralph?
What's up, Uncle Ralph?
It's your boy Flip De Niro. Fabulous.
Fat Joe to ULE. And we live on the Hush Hip Hop Tour.
Ralph McDaniels, Hush Hip Hop Tours. We are in the bus. We just touched down in Queens, New York. It's going down. What up, baby?
What up,
yes, indeed. We in the bridge right now. You see what it is.
It ain't hard to tell. I excel, then prevail. The mic is contacted. I attract clientele. My mic check is like
destination Queens Bridge, New York, home of Nas. Home of course, Mobb Deep, legendary group. Home of my man, MC Shan, Marley Marl, Roxanne, Shanté. They all grew up over here, right here in this project. It's going down right here. We in the bridge, baby. And it's Uncle Ralph, and we navigating through.
Dress like Motrin, then extend strong. I drink my wet with Medusa, give us shotguns in hell. From the summit I lived in hell, it ain't hard to tell.
One of the first videos I worked on was for a guy named Nas, Nasty Nas. Coming out of this project right here, Queensbridge. We did a video for the song, It Ain't Hard to Tell. Let me tell y'all, crazy. Going down, the bridge is hot. Gunshots is going off. This is the 90s, this is the crack era. A lot happened, and Nas says, yo, Ralph, I wanna look out for the crew, man. So I don't think we should shoot the video in Queensbridge. I think we should do it in Manhattan. I said, but you from the bridge? He says, yeah, but I wanna look out for the crew because there's a lot of gang stuff going on. There's a lot of shootings going on. So we end up shooting that video, not here in the bridge, but in Coney Island and Long Island City and LES. That's Nas, baby, looking out for people, making sure that everybody was safe right here, Queens, New York. Roxanne Shanté is in the building. What's good, girl?
What's going on? How are you?
Tell us a little bit about Roxanne's Revenge and how that started off.
DJ Marley Marl happened to call me out of his window and was like, listen, you know, I heard that you're a great battle rapper. And at that time, I had built a name up for myself for being one of the best battle rappers in the city. And he said, look, I got this beat and I want to hear you just do a quick freestyle. So I was like, look, I'm in the middle of doing my laundry. I got about maybe 10 minutes to move. So it's gonna take me like 2 minutes to get there. So it's gonna be about 7 minutes to rhyme. But I gotta get back to doing this laundry. And I went to his house, and in one take, I did Roxanne's Revenge.
Well, my name is Roxanne. I don't say no, I just a cold rocker party, and I do this show. I said I met these three guys, and you know it's true. Let me tell you.
They played it on a radio, and I remember coming outside the next day and literally becoming Roxanne Shanté overnight. We met you because they were like, you know, you're gonna make a video. And I was like, what, a video? I was like, okay, let me get dressed up. Let me get ready. We're going to make a video. I remember you saying, okay, listen, you're going to get, you got a limo. Because I think one of the neighbors on the street, their limo was parked outside. And I was like, oh, okay, so we're going to get in a limo and ride? You was like, no, we're going to get in the limo. You're going to walk around. You're going to walk back out. I said, like a clown car? You said, exactly, like a clown car, everybody. We're going to get out and pretend like we're in this limo. And I thought that that was hilarious, but it was so sincere. I remember you bringing everybody heroes. That's right. There was no buffets, no catering. You would have got everybody heroes from the corner store. It was like, okay, yes. Look, here's the food. And it just led for a great day. And I think that day made me love hip hop even more. Yeah. You know, everybody just pitched in what they had. And look what we did. We created history.
I want to know why. Why'd you have to make a record about me? The R-O-X-A-N-N-E.
Hey, look, you're not going to believe this, but I'm in Queensbridge Houses where you grew up at.
You know, Queensbridge is the largest housing project in the world. And wow. You're talking about 96 buildings. You're talking about over 6 blocks. You're talking over 30,000 tenants on any given day. So wow. When you grew up in Queensbridge, you didn't just grow up in a project. One thing about Queensbridge is that when you grow up there, you never forget anything about Queensbridge. Like, if I was to lose my sight, I could walk through Queensbridge completely and know every place I'm at.
Here. You know what? I mean, it's always like to me, like you were like a well-rounded artist. What does it mean to be from Queens and an artist coming out? Because the legacy has always been tight. Everybody's always done their thing.
My Queens roots run deep, man, because I've been a part of so many circles in Queens. You know, from you know, going back to Lost Boys and Onyx. You know, we was all over at John Adams High School and shit together, you know. Yeah, so I watched a lot of it all unfold. And then being from Hollis, you know, Run DMC and LL Cool J right there from Farmers, my MC roots are very well rooted when you talk about Queens. And then, you know, Nas is the homie from over in Queensbridge. And then, you know, me and Fifth had beef, so, you know, it's like, I covered all the bases in Queens, you know what I'm saying?
And Queens always have those official colors, man, something different.
Queens is different, man. We our own animal out in Queens. You know what I mean, Rob? It's something in the water about Queens. There's so many artists that came from Queens.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. I mean, the list is long of hip-hop artists that were successful from Queens.
Yeah.
I mean, and you know, the Godfather, Russ, is... He definitely put just about every artist you could think of on the map when it comes to Queens, and taught all of the moguls how to do what they do. So, yeah, man, Queens, we did a lot of hip hop. When you gonna think about Queens, man? Back in the days, man, it was you or bust, Rob. So, man, I salute you, King. We appreciate you, man. And hip hop wouldn't be where it's at without you. So you know the drill.
Ralph McDaniels, we are here. We are in Hollis, Queens, doing what we do. Like, you know, I told y'all, I grew up in this neighborhood. Been down from the 80s. My man Jam Master Jay, who I know for years, been holding it down. This is how we do it. Run DMC way, Jam Master Jay, 2/5 in Hollis. We've been doing it like this since the 80s, baby.
Yeah, I make it happen. I stay with a bad bitch, make no mistake. You know that she packing. The gang is out, move. All of my hitters, they shoot. Gorillas out. Ooh, oh, we coming, they don't make a move. It's dinner time, you fool. Yeah, my hoodie stay with a two. And my bitches stay with Chanel bags. And they pack a 38 too. The gang is out, move. All of my hitters, they shoot. Gorillas out, ooh. We coming, they don't make a move. It's dinner time, you fool.
Tell us about this ground right here, because this St. Albans and Southside and Northside, there's a lot of history right here.
It is. Me, I know this is the DMC side, Run DMC, very legendary side of Queens.
Oh, all right, so you hearing all this music as a little one coming up?
Growing up, actually, I played ball, so I never even thought I would be rapping right now. Yeah, very, that's the thing, I'm very competitive, so I'm competitive on myself.
Yeah.
I ain't graduate college, but they acknowledge my talent, soon as I step in. On the grind way before reaching my adolescence, cash.
What influences what you do today? You know, who you are, who you become?
You know, it's funny, believe it or not, I like R&B. So, I have a lot of aunts. I have a big family. They're predominantly female. So, but rap wise, I used to listen to a lot of DMX when I was supposed to. I grew up, I listened to DMX. Yeah. Hope, of course.
Yes.
But when I got into hip hop, of course, I did my homework and.
Lyrics?
Yeah.
Like, you known for that?
Absolutely.
Was there pressure on you coming up that you had to show out like that?
When I write, I do music, I try to make sure my bars or my freestyle, whatever it is better than the last one or can keep up with the last one. So, been coming from Queens, is a very competitive borough. I just go hard with everything I do.
North side, south side, Queens, stand up. We've been out here all day. And of course, we had to catch the future legend, Kyah Baby.
Kyah Baby, young goat.
Hopping out, you know it's sun when the doors lift. Queens get the money, we only stacking it up with. G's stay icy, cause shit gets spicy. She on demon time, I get her a timepiece.
Yeah. DJ Camilo.
What's up, baby?
Amazing neighborhood. Amazing place you have called Blends Astoria.
That's right, Blends Astoria. Amazing. We should go sit down and eat something.
All right, let's do it, man. So, Camilo, tell me, what is Blends? Why did you call it Blends?
So, when me and my partners got together and had a bright idea to open a restaurant, which we know nothing about, mm-hmm. you know, we wanted to do Latin food, but what we wanted to do was blend in different dishes from different Latin countries. So, we have a Brazilian dish, a Peruvian dish, a Colombian dish, a Puerto Rican, a Dominican dish, all in one Latin spot, which you can't find really, you know?
Yes.
And then on top of that, you know, I'm a DJ.
Right.
I mix, I blend, I rock, you know?
That's what I thought it was, you know? But I like the way you're mixing the different cultures and the taste. I remember, I think I have pictures of you playing out of your crates back in the
day. Oh, 100%. Well, that's how I grew up learning the craft. I started in the early 90s, mid 90s with the mixtape game. Yeah. Back then it was just vinyl.
Right.
It was nothing else.
Wow.
You know, then the CDJs came and all that. But yeah. My vinyl collection, I still have it.
Still have it.
I refuse to get rid of it. I worked yes. too hard for it. I, yes. you know, that's a beauty, man. Hopefully vinyl never dies.
I remember when you first came to Hot 97 and you had flyers that were very colorful. The artwork was different
right.
than everybody else's. And then on the other side, it would say how many dates you had.
Right. You know what? I come from the mixtape game where everything was promo. Mm-hmm. It's just not like how nice you are on the set. What I would do is hit the club and on the low, give out all to the other people. Club owners used to hate that.
Right.
You know, but that was part of my game. I was always promoting.
Yeah. I think I might have a couple of those flyers somewhere in the stash, but I took it home with me to study the vibe on it, you know.
Right.
But you're right. You did. You broke the game with that, man. Astoria, we here. Let's get it moving. Hush Hip Hop Tours.